What is up, everybody? Good morning. Today is Wednesday, June 30th. I hope you are strapped in. Today is going to be wild. There is a lot going on. And yeah, let's just jump right into it because there is no delay in the news and what is going to happen in the next 24 hours. First up, Punk's Comic Edition 2. Voting has ended for round one with the first 64, so we're down to 32. A lot of people are excited for this, and I've been really happy to see a lot of the losers are jumping on to the team of the person they lost to, supporting them, telling their followers and fans to rally and support the victor. I'm currently on to round two. Big shout out to Ape Number 1979. I appreciate all the kind words. There's going to be some very, very interesting matchups here. A lot of good apes paired up against each other. It's going to be interesting to see like Tropo versus Benjamin down here. That'll certainly lead to some Twitter conversations and hopefully some humor for everybody. So voting opens up back on the 1st of July, Thursday. Get out there and vote, support people, engage with the community. Interesting price action last night. Worth noting that, you know, we saw the floor on projects that get hyped up, get bought, and it gets pumped. It's super easy to manipulate a floor, like, you know, send it from 0.1 to 1 Ethereum with a couple ETH. So, you know, I saw this happen last night where we saw the Board Punk Yacht Club floor go from, like, I think it was like 0.2 or something, just get bought up all the way to 0.5. And then it continued, went to 0.89, then 0.9, and then it went all the way to 1. So we had a bunch of purchases at 1. And then right after that, we saw the prices start to, get sold into from some of these people who were buying down at 0.1 to the 0.2 area, even lower than that. But essentially, we saw this whole rise up. People FOMO'd in, and then people who bought low just started dumping, and the floor is already crashing. Just something to keep an eye out on as these things take off. Crypto Beast has been all over my timeline. If you haven't seen it, when egg, all the egg posts, DM for egg. I like Tommy and Dom, who are behind this project. They're cool and good friends of mine. I'm not going to shill too hard, but it's a cool project. I like the dynamics that you get an egg, you don't know what's coming, the mystery behind it, and they're giving stuff away for free. So if you haven't tried to get an egg, I'm not gonna tell you to spend money on the secondary, obviously, but it's a cool project. Do your own research, and very cool project. But like I was saying, there's so much happening today. There's going to be a lot of drops. If you need to do something that requires gas, get it done like now. Starting this afternoon, there's just going to be drops on drops on drops. Art Blocks is dropping Eccentrics by Rob Dixon at 6 p.m. That is going to be, I think, only a few hundred drops at 0.12 Ethereum. That'll sell out in under a minute, guaranteed. We also have Absurd Bortium. This is a project that I've been chatting with the owners. I really like the visuals. It seems like they've put a lot of effort into what they're doing. This is a drop that a lot of hype has just, attached itself to over the last 24, 48 hours. They changed the way they're going to do this drop. I think there's like 6,666 trees. Phase one is only going to be 3,333 trees, and then there'll be a second phase. I believe this drop is still going to be on July 1st, worth keeping an eye on. Today, we have also Forgotten Runes Wizard's Cult. This will happen at approximately 10:30 Central Daylight Time. This is going to be a drop I see a lot of people going into. It's got that, retro feel. The pixel art is really cool. There's a lot of cool attributes. I am very interested in this. Definitely do some research on this one. I'm expecting this to sell out. There's also Mad Cat Militia today. I could not figure out what time this was going to be at. I think it's going to be at like 6 p.m. as well. There seems to be some people with eyes on this project. Do your own research, as I've said, for that, you know, previous projects and all the other projects I mentioned today. But this also seems to have some interesting art, another cat project, but we'll see what happens. There's also Lucky Maneki collectibles. These are also dropping today, and I believe the time that we'll see these drop is at 1 p.m. Eastern time. Certainly, a lot of people have been talking about this. I've seen people that I normally don't see talk about drops talking about Lucky. There seems to be a very interesting reward schema to the drop and to the project. Do your own research. And yeah, that drops at one. A really cool project called Deadheads. Awesome art. Really cool 3D visuals. It's really cool. Like, it's at 330. I think the price is like above 0.1 Ethereum. The whole theme to it is that it's these like dead, morbid degens and about a disrupted land, and it's just got a cool vibe to it, cool story. I know a lot of people are going to buy into this expecting that to sell out. You can go and check out more about the project on deadheads.io. I like the 3D visuals that we're also seeing here. The UI is really sleek, and their roadmap to what they're doing seems to be well thought out, and there seems to be a lot of community thought into the project as well. Also, we have CryptoSnoos from Reddit ending today. My prediction was that we saw this end, the above 20 and near 40 would not surprise me. There's about 7 hours left. Top bid is 6, 5, and 10 for each of these. I think I'm expecting the original block one to go for, that close to 40 range. I could be way off on this. I do see these having lots of value and a bidding war cranking out at the end. Worth keeping an eye on. So these will end right around, I think that'll be like 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock p.m. on Eastern Coast. Also ending today at 2 p.m. Eastern time is FEWOCiOUS's 5-lot art gallery pieces on Christie's. Yeah, so these are all at like 200,000. There's one at 350,000. Do we see a $1 million FEWOCiOUS piece today? I think so. Like, I'm going to go out and put it on the record. We will see a $1 million FEWOCiOUS sale today. This is going to be, it's a huge, huge deal. FEWOCiOUS is an amazing artist. He's got a really interesting story. And it's awesome to see somebody go from just making art to his life completely changing in the matter of a couple months. And I know the NFT community is really proud and happy to support him. And he's kind of, leading the charge for NFTs, on a global conversation scale as he goes on a lot of these news networks and gets all this global attention. So 4 hours, 13 minutes remaining on these pieces. Number year two, age 15. My mama's dream has the highest bid currently at $300,050. Like I said, I'm expecting these to go plus a million, will be a big deal. In what seems to be the catalyst for photography in the NFT space, Justin Avasario. Sano, oh my God, Justin, I'm sorry, I butchered your last name there. And D's last night kicking off a super long Twitter Spaces conversation, which ended up with D's buying a piece from Kath. This piece went for 4.5 ETH and was accompanied with a trip as well, I believe. I think we're about to see photography NFTs get really, really hot. The conversation and the narrative over the last 24 hours has really shifted to, okay, who are the best photographers? How can we improve photography in the space? And I'm really excited to see that. congrats to D's. Justin also being one of the biggest proponents in the photography space. Excited to see what happens next there. Getting to floor prices, we see that Bored Ape Yacht Club is down again to the mid twos, mid-low, high twos. This is interesting. I just think the hype is dying down a little bit. We're getting back to reality. Again, don't see prices going lower than 2.5. Bored Ape Kennel Club, however, still weak on the floor. A lot of price action that we're seeing seems to be around the floor. Not a lot in the highs. I'm seeing mostly trades for high-end stuff. So if you have something that's a little bit higher end and you don't have that liquidity or you're not having any bids, it's worth trying to put a trade out there. Hopefully somebody picks it up and you can get on with that. Mebits floor is sitting, yesterday was right around 1 Ethereum. Today we are still sitting near that, I believe. Mebits getting some attention. We're breaking through 1 Ethereum. So floor's at 1.08. I just think this slowly crawls up over the next week, as I've said before. Wicked Craniums also sitting similar to where they were yesterday. Yesterday we saw about a 0.223 floor still sitting there. No big changes. I know Gutter Cats have been getting quite the hype lately. There was an airdrop snapshot yesterday. The floor is now up to 2. Yesterday morning was a 1 Ethereum floor. So if you bought yesterday, you're up huge. Excited to see this project keep taking off. And Wicked, from there, we're also going to look at Polymorphs. Polymorphs floor is now 0.055. The floor has been interesting here. I think we saw a lot of hype after that Twitter Spaces talk. And we went from 0.01 all the way up to 0.075, 0.08. And now we're kind of coming back to, okay, I bought low, time to take some profit. I think we'll see this settle out right around 0.05. Don't see any other big price movements here. Again, it's got utility to it. It's interesting. And the conversation narrative on Twitter has been positive around it. Punk still sitting at about a 17 Ethereum floor. This, I think we're going to see this floor also slowly increase like Mebits. Punks are back. And I think the floor has just been where we've seen most of the sales happening. Yeah, so between the 17 to 25 Ethereum range, that's where a lot of the sales have happened. We did see a big boy sale come through at 75 Ethereum 7 hours ago for this VR Punk. And we also saw some big bids come in. We saw a top head bid come in for like 150 Ethereum. That was declined, however, and you know, this is great. I'm glad to see that we're having action on the floor, and it's interesting that we're seeing all this action as Ethereum is taking off from its bottoms. On that note, Ethereum yesterday kind of topped out around $2,200 and pulled back about 5% to the low 2100s. This morning, we're kind of crawling back from that pullback back to 2150. Bitcoin doing the same thing, the whole market kind of following along as usual. We're just kind of in this like waiting phase. We don't know where we're going to go. The charts look interesting. I've heard very smart people saying that was the bottom and we're up from here. I've also heard the other side of very smart people saying that, hey, that could have been, but I'm not, fully certain where we go from there. As always, make sure you're keeping track of your trades and your positions and that you're not in anything too risky. I wouldn't be leveraged right now for sure. That is certain. As we go into a United States holiday weekend, I can guarantee you there's going to be some crazy price movement. We've seen this the last, 5 years. Whenever there's a holiday or something going on, there is usually some craziness in the prices of crypto. So certainly keep an eye on that and make sure you're not in any risky situations. But yeah, that's the info for today. A lot of drops happening. I'm going to try to link below a list of all those so it's easy to track. And I would certainly keep your eye on this FEWOCiOUS auction. My prediction, like I said, is that we see million plus prices, and this kind of, you know, this is just the start for him. I think anybody who buys at that price is probably going to get a really good steal on some great artwork that'll appreciate in the long term. With that said, this is the June 30th show for Morning Mint. Hope you have a great day. Stay positive. Share some love on Twitter today. And good luck minting.